and then we'll go forward from there. So, amen.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord again.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord again.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord again.
Praise the Lord.
Come on, y'all. Let's put our hands together. Our gladness said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. It is good to be in the presence of God. Notice that I didn't say it's good to just come to church. I said it is good to be in the presence of God. Amen. We're going to start off this morning. I ask that if you are able to stand to your feet, that you join me on my feet as we welcome the Lord into the house of the Lord. Amen.
Welcome into this place.
Thank you.
the Lord on this morning. Children, stand as we go before the Lord on this morning.
Thank you. Please gather. Jesus answered and said, "The voice came not because of me, but for your sakes. Now is the judgment of this world. Now
Welcome to Greater Bethlehem Temple World Ministries. Shall we tithe our gross or our net?
As the joy tithe.
choir.
What is God's promise to the tithe? All together,
God love a cheerful
giver. It is more blessed to give than to receive.
And I know
voluntarily. Father God, in the name of Jesus, we just thank you for just your love, your kindness, your tender mercies, God. We just thank you for just being our provider, oh Lord God. We just thank you for just your faithfulness and your mercies, oh Lord God. We ask, Father God, that you bless this offering, oh Lord. Bless the giver and the gift, oh Lord God. I pray, Father God, that you bless your people, oh Lord, those that seek employment, those that seek increase, oh Lord, those that seek promotions, oh Lord God. We pray, Father God, that you bless them, oh Lord God, even right now, oh Lord. You ask to give back a portion of what you have blessed them, oh Lord. In the name of Jesus, we thank you and praise you, oh Lord. Meet the needs of this house, oh Lord. We'll be forever be so grateful and thankful in Jesus' name. Forward. Hallelujah. We thank the Lord just even for jobs, for the strength, even just to be able to work, even just to give back the portion, which is the 10%, which is the first 10 that the Lord has. And then if the youth are available, my brothers to come, if the youth are available to pass out envelopes, you can identify if you need an offering envelope.
Thank you.
GBTWM grew up here, one of the young people here at Greater Bethlehem Temple. Amen. And Minister Brittany Norwood, Minister Brittany Norwood, she'll be going first. Amen. And we just want to just praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Mama said she wasn't in the room. We're going to have to come forward. Hopefully, the young people are very passionate about the Word of God. Definitely love God's people. Amen. Even people in heart and a product of greater Bethlehem Temple. So we're going to bring Minister Brittany Norwood.
Trying to do. to destroy the law or the prophets. I am not come to destroy, but to defeat, but to fulfill. So I don't want y'all to think that I'm up here saying that you can go out and you can do wrong and that only God can judge you, because that's not what I'm saying. Because the Bible also tells us, what's the scripture, that if grace shall abound,
thank you.
he kept pushing because he knew that his ultimate plan was to please his Father in heaven. That the ultimate plan was pleasing God. And that he had to get the word out no matter what. That he had to get the word out. I know God is pushing people, telling you to go forth. To go forth. So now is the time. You don't have to wait any longer. Don't go to 1 Thessalonians 2 and 4. And I'm giving out these scriptures so that you can know them and so that you won't think that this is something that I'm just saying, something that I'm just making up. And one thing about the Bible is it's not a fairy tale book. It's not a story like Jackie Jill. It's not a story like Humpty Dumpty sat on the wall. But it's a history book, right? We got some history inside of here. But this is real life. It's not fake. These are not characters in a book and they're just a made-up story, a fictional story. But this is truth. This is life. This is reality.
Yes, hallelujah.
But as we were allowed, God, to be put in trust with the gospel, even so we speak, not as pleasing men, but God, which triumph our hearts. One thing about God is he knew our hearts. So he know if we trying to do stuff out of rebellion. He know if we trying to do things just because we mad. He know our hearts.
Yeah. Thank you, Lord.
We look a little sad. Like we don't know the word. Like we don't know what's going on. But I thought this word would inspire some people. I thought this word would help some people because a lot of times we feel like where people that come to us and they say that, well, maybe you're not called for that. Or maybe you shouldn't sing that song. Or maybe you shouldn't preach that message or teach that or do that and all of that stuff. But God said, if I don't convince you, don't worry about what others say. God is calling people now to step out. To step out of those unfamiliar places. And he's telling you that if I don't convince you, that you don't have to worry about what anybody else said. You don't have to worry about what man would do to you because it's only one person that can destroy the body and the spirit. And that is Christ. And our ultimate goal is to please Christ. Does anybody want to please Christ or is it just me? Is it just me?
Leviticus 26:11-13. said unto God, Behold, when I come unto the children of Israel, and shall say unto them, that God, the God of your fathers, hath sent me unto you, and they say unto me, What is his name? What shall I say unto you? And God said unto Moses, I am that I am. And he said, Thus shalt thou say unto the children, I am, having sent me unto you. And now we'll go over to Leviticus 26, 11 through 13. And I will set my tabernacle against amongst you, and my soul shall not harbor you. And I will walk among you, and I will be your God, and ye shall be my people. I am the Lord your God, which brought you forth out of the land of Egypt, that ye shall not be their bondsmen, and I have broken the bonds of your yoke and made you go afraid. And my thought for today is simple. I am that I am. With the cold sermon of He's mine and I'm His. I'm on assignment to remind us who God is. I'm here to remind us today through the Word of God that He is everything you need and more. God said to remind the people that I did what I did for Abraham in Genesis 22 when He took His son Isaac to be a sacrifice for God. Just before He was about to take the knife and to Him, the angel of the Lord called out to Him and said, Abraham, Abraham. And He said, Here I am. And He said, Lay not thy hand upon the lad, neither do thou anything unto him. For now I know that thou fearest God, seeing thou hast not withheld thy son, thy only son, from me. Verse number 13, And Abraham lifted up his eyes, and looked, and behold, behind him a ram caught in the thicket, and his horns, and Abraham, by his horns, and Abraham went and took the ram and offered it up for a burnt offering instead of his son. Verse number 14, And Abraham called the name of that place Jehovah Jireh, as it is said to this day, in the mouth of the Lord it shall be seen. The word Jehovah Jireh, the Lord our provider. His word tells us that He will supply our every need according to His riches and His glory. So God said, Remind my people, hallelujah, that in time of need, I am your Jehovah Jireh, your provider. In time of trouble, I am your refuge. Which simply means to be safe or sheltered from pursuit, danger, or trouble. In time of weakness, I, the Lord, am your strength. Psalms 46 and 1 sums it up nicely, and it says, God is our refuge and our strength, a very present help in trouble. In times of attack, I am the Lord your buckler, hallelujah. In Genesis 15 and 1, God told Abraham to fear not, I am your shield. So this is why when the weapon is formed by me, it cannot prosper. Hallelujah. Oh, glory to his name. When the enemy comes in like a flood, this is why the Spirit of the Lord lifts up a standard against it. Because he is the Lord, our protector. He said, tell my people, I am your peace. I am your joy. I am your redeemer. Hallelujah. I am your sustenance. I am your waymaker. Hallelujah. I am your savior. Glory to God. Excuse me. Hallelujah. As I change pages. Your sustainer. I am your hope. Hallelujah. He says, tell my people, I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end, the first and the last. He said, tell my people, I am Jehovah Rapha. Exodus 15:26, the end of the verse states, for I am the Lord.
It doesn't matter what I did.
only sees me for who I am. And I'm here to tell you, He's mine and I am His. It doesn't matter what I did. He only sees me for who I am. So that means when I was in my sin, He saw the best in me. When I was in my sin, He said that I am your God and ye are my people. When I was in my sin, He said, my mercy shall not depart from me. He's mine and I am His. So people of God, you got to remember the God that you serve. You got to remember that He is the great I Am. Hallelujah. You got to remember that when you are sick, He is your healer. Hallelujah. You got to remember when you are depressed that He is a comforter. Hallelujah. You got to remember that God is God Almighty. And He's Almighty, powerful God, all by Himself. Hallelujah. He does not need help. Hallelujah. I am your God. And you are my people. He's a way maker. When the children of Israel, your mother, came to the Red Sea, glory to God, they looked around and they didn't know what they were going to do. Hallelujah. They didn't know what place they could go. Hallelujah. But who did they have to count on? The great I Am. So what did God do? He opened up an entire sea and allowed His people to walk across on dry land. Scripture proves that He's the way maker. Scripture proves that He's a miracle worker. Hallelujah. I'm thinking of it as this right now, hallelujah. How God allowed her heart to make His own bypass. A miracle worker. I'm thinking of, hallelujah, Bishop and First Lady. How many times death knocked on their doors, hallelujah. But God said no, hallelujah. I'm your man, maker, hallelujah. I'm your miracle worker. I'm thinking about how long my wife was without a child. And we didn't know where to turn. But we did not miss that one time. We did not miss that one offering, hallelujah. And we kept the faith, hallelujah. That's how I know that God is a sustainer, hallelujah. We did not get our car repossessed. We did not go home in that one time. Hallelujah. Not one time. So when He said, I am your God, I am your sustainer. Hallelujah. I can testify to that. I can believe in that. That I'm your sustainer. In me, you can trust. So we as God's people, we have to lay down the doubt. We have to lay down all things that's not like God. And just let God be God. Hallelujah. His word said, prove me now. Test me now. Come on, woman, you try. Oh, taste and see that the Lord is good. A struggle a few years ago, hallelujah. I was in with you and praying with you. And next thing you know, I was on the floor, hallelujah, giving God the glory, giving God the praise. And next thing you know, hallelujah, I had my breakthrough, hallelujah. And he said, I am the God that gives breakthroughs. I am your God who gives deliverance. I am your God who gives you joy. I am your God who gives you peace.
Miracle worker, promise keeper, guiding the Thank you.
Remember, oh Lord, even the celebration of the Brittany and Pink, oh Lord, pray, Father God.